right? Think about it this way, guys. Shoe on the other foot. Imagine it's like right-wing protesters and they're chanting crazy stuff about trans people, and the person in there is a left-wing speaker as trans speaker, right? And she's scared for her life in there, and the right-wingers are chanting, chanting, and the cops say to the trans activist, it's not safe to go outside. We're worried that they're going to harm you, right? Now, what would our community, the left, say?
I mean, you know.
You know what we would say. Yeah. We would say those right-wingers are monsters. Let her out. Let her out, right? So don't be hypocritical. Please, I'm begging you. I know it's so hard. We get into into individual camps. And no, everything on the left has to be right. Nope, everything on the right has to be right. Right? No, that protest got out of hand the minute it felt that it became physically unsafe. Right? Do not lose the moral high ground. You had everything right. Right? Think about it this way, guys.
So yeah, the heat on the Young Turks has not let up, and stay in tune to find more. So before we go any further, I'm going to ask you please like, share, comment, and subscribe. It helps the channel out a lot. Yes, you won't find anybody talking about this anywhere else on YouTube because everybody else has all agreed not to talk about this group of people. The Young Turks, being clout chasers that they are, tend to get themselves embroiled in scandal so that people will talk about them. But now they're starting to realize the futility of the way that their side has been handling themselves. And that to sit there and scream that conservatives are terrible, meanwhile doing the exact same things that they claim conservatives do, is not a great image. And so now they're trying to correct, I guess, the mistakes that they've made, and now they're having to deal with the repercussions of pushing those ideologies. They're trying to hop on the moderate bandwagon of like, I'm not a far left-wing person, while other people are like, I'm not a far right-wing person. We've all been radicalized, but that's not the point of it. The point of this is that they talk about this radicalization where both sides have seemed to be pulled into a similar mindset despite their vast differences in how they believe. Guys, I know why. I'll tell you exactly why. It's because they're paid by the same people. The same people are pushing the same motives, the same goals, and the same agendas. They want us to fight each other. They want us to be weak. They want us to hate each other, and they want us to be in places where we're in pure poverty and blaming someone that's also in pure poverty in comparison to how these people live. I'm talking about, you talk about like mobility in life and be able to go anywhere you want. These people can literally go anywhere in a day. They're the type of people that they can call, a jet's going to show up, and they can just go because they felt. Anything less than that, to them, you're a peasant, right? So realize that they've all kept us fighting each other. I don't know, maybe this is time that we reach across the aisle. Try to say, hey, we have disagreed on things before, but we see that you recognize something that's true. Maybe we can work to build off it. I mean, any great thing that's ever happened in terms of cool things for human freedom happening has come from collaborative effort of individuals that don't agree. I mean, even look at the experiment that is America, right? Is a collection of people that had different ideologies, different beliefs that came together and said, well, we should at least have the right to govern ourselves. And so let's let it lay out a framework by which that we can accomplish this. Fought together in many different battles to try to overthrow the bondage that they had been put under. So guys, when you see a group of people that you might not have always agreed with, and you might not like very much, but they're saying things that are right and true because they're having a realization, maybe we should give them the chance. So, I'm not going to be watching them or anything, but I'm keep an eye out for them, Look, we all go through changes and journeys in our life. That's the point of knowing God. He puts us on a journey and travels us through life to change into something that's pure and righteous so that we repent for our sins and our failures, that we don't be conformed to the ways of the world, we're changed from it, right? So let's encourage change in other people so that we're not just pushing them back in the same place. Be the servant that forgives as much as they were forgiven. I want to thank you guys for joining, and please, have a blessed day.